All right, so this is a video of the trailer that I posted on LinkedIn. I got a bunch of interest on it, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a video. I'm gonna try to keep it quick because the last camera I was using, I was only able to do like 20-minute videos, and apparently I'm not as good at editing videos as I am at building trailers. So I'm just gonna do a quick overview, basically, of the trailer. So I'll probably pause and then press record again in the middles when I'm trying to show some features. So here it goes. Just back up, obviously, and then I have this lift here. It's a trailer jack lift. I got it from, I actually bought this one off of Amazon, but the first one I had, I got from Northern Tools, about $170. Trailer's really tongue heavy because of the way that I built it. Obviously, having the mower on the front makes it a little bit heavier than it would be if it was, you know, on the back like most other trailers. So you can see, obviously, you see how this works. The funny thing is I'm sure somebody will notice that the wire's not hooked up, but the jack still works. That's because there's a battery on the trailer. So I'm gonna pause it now, get it finished hooked up, and then pull it out of the garage so you guys can see what the deal is. All right, so she's all up, so I'm about to pull it out here. All right, so this trailer was a 6.5 by 12 foot triple crown. It had 24 inch sides on it, or still does have 24 inch sides on it. It was just a base utility trailer with a gate on the back. It didn't have any racks or anything. I actually used it for a small demo business I was doing at the time for rehabs. So, you know, I kind of sat at jobs for a while, and that was kind of that. But when I started doing preservation, I bought some box trucks, and then I started building some dovetails and realized that, you know, it really, to be honest with you, box trucks kind of cost some money to run. They cost a lot to fix. Here they cost a lot to register and a lot to insure. So, as work slowed down, I kind of started getting rid of the box trucks and I decided to, start the process of building this thing. So this is, it's kind of its final iteration. It's just, kind of a culmination of a bunch of years. There was a lot of stuff I put on here and then cut off, and, you know, I didn't really scratch build it. It was more like a, you know, I built something, I didn't like it, I took it off. I built something, and then I did a specific type of job for a while, and then I wasn't doing those type of jobs anymore, so I changed. One of the reasons why I built a dump on the back is because I was doing a lot of Wells Fargo properties, and there was a lot of leaf cleanups. And I just thought that it would make more sense to have a dump. So I'm gonna grab the remote that runs the trash can dumper, and I'll show you that feature, and then I'll walk around the rest of the trailer and show you what the deal is. All right, so on the back of the trailer, let's start at the front. That's a 15-gallon fuel tank. I got that from Northern Tool. This is a generator. It was just a 5,500-watt Coleman PowerMate 6250 peak, I think. I pulled it out of the frame and welded up some brackets to bolt it to the trailer. And then I fed it off of this fuel tank that also has, you know, a fuel nozzle for the mower, or mixed two cycle. I cut the panel off of it and welded it here on the side of the trailer so that it's easier to access. And I just basically extended the service wires from there. Here I built a box. I built this box. It's kind of a scrap piece was basically before I was sure that I was going to like it there. But the chainsaw's in there. There's a 18-inch Echo chainsaw. This is my handheld blower. It's basically just sitting on a rack that's in front of the mower. Used to be a backpack blower rack that I built that was here. But as we're not cleaning a bunch of leaves up anymore, I use this handheld for simple grass cuts. So that's the electrical panel, obviously. Weed kill mix. Some hand loppers here. I'm using a Harbor Freight hose reel to wrap up my extension cords. I have the male end zip strapped in here, and then I've got a short cord that goes from here and wraps around and comes up here. So basically I can just pull the cord out as far as I need it, and then when I'm done I walk back over and I plug this in, and then the cord's it's got power. This is actually a mount that holds my cell phone. It's magnetic on both ends. It's here because I had my phone hooked up there, so that doesn't need to go there. But anyway, this is, I'm trying to do this quick, I'm sorry if I'm talking fast. This is a hose that comes from a water tank on the other side of the trailer. It's a 15-gallon water tank. This lever here, when you push it forward, lets water come out there. And then when you turn on this switch, it sends water through the pump, so it comes out faster. And then you can slow this down, and as you slow it down, the water comes out slower, so you don't waste it. That's for if I'm mixing weed kill or filling up a bucket to clean toilets. You can close that valve and open the other one. And this one basically is just for washing hands and anything else where the high hose would be more sense. This is a 2-inch piece of PVC, two caps on the end. This cap has some holes drilled in it, so that there's no suction when the when you turn this, some soap comes out. It's just dish soap. I grab them from whatever house I'm working in, because there's dish soap everywhere. The other stuff is pretty self-explanatory. There's gas cans and bar and chain lube. This is a Kobalt 8-gallon air compressor. It stays on the trailer. It's bolted on. And it feeds my 100-foot air hose, which is right there. I got a Echo Weed Eater, Echo Hedge Clippers, Echo Pole Saw. The holders for these were actually designed for a box truck. I had them in my box truck. They go on the wall. They do not lock, so I got cables on all of my hand tools here, and then I have a padlock that's welded in. Obviously it won't keep a determined thief from taking my stuff, but if I'm running into Home Depot or something, it stays pretty secure. So compressor. Oh, there was two switches on this box here. This switch here runs that light bar right there. It's magnetic, and it has about a 10 or 12 foot cord on it. It's so that I can put it in a different location, and you know, if I need it for light. I also have light bars on all four corners of the lower part of the trailer here. Those come on when I put the truck in reverse, so that I can see all around the ground when I'm backing into my garage here. Or I can also turn on a bypass switch that turns on all of the lights at nighttime, so I can see everywhere. Ladder rack. I put a lot of thought into how I could do this, because the ladder rack kind of took up a lot of room. A lot of times it has to telescope up, and then, you know, you got to come over and then go up again so that you can hang the ladder on it. This is just a bar that goes between my posts for my weed eater and chainsaw and all that stuff, or pole saw. And there are just two stakes that go inside the rungs here, and they go up about halfway, and that's how the ladder stays in place. Just two stakes off of a piece of inch and a quarter, or inch and a half, I'm sorry, square tube, which is incidentally what most of the stuff on this trailer is made out of. Back axle has brakes. I put those on for winterization stuff, cleaning toilets, obviously all that stuff. I got a hose here for draining water heaters. If you look here at this little bar that goes right here, it's a tarping system that I made. If you push down on that, the tarp comes up. I'll try to do it and hold the camera at the same time. Push down, tarp comes up and over, and it actually overextends the back of the gate by about 2 feet, so that if the trailer is a little over full, it still has room to close. Self-explanatory hand tools there. What else? Okay, so back here, you can see I got the light bars, one there and one over there. Those are reverse lights. That right there is a trash can dumper. A trash can goes in there, and then I push this button, and it goes up. And while it's up, you can see I put some gas struts here to help with the shaking of it. And also they're 112 pound per cylinder lift. So it's about 224 pounds of lift. That helps helps this system here that I made. Basically, it's just a Harbor Freight 2,500 pound winch motor. And then I bought some sprockets and some shafts and some chain off of Surplus Center and put that together. It was kind of a crude thing. I bolted it all on because I wasn't sure it was going to work. And it actually worked as soon as I made it. I did add those gas struts later. But yeah, they definitely help a lot. It lifts about 60 pounds, 50 or 60 pounds. I know that's not a lot, or it doesn't sound like a lot, but if you're running around doing a clean out and you're dumping 50 pound trash cans in the back of your trailer, you'll hope you have one of these, or at least you'll be happy. I did even consider taking this thing off because it's so heavy on the gate. But you know, I just used it enough that it wasn't, I decided it was probably better to leave it. So there's no limit switches on this. You can put it too tight and it will go until it stops, basically. So you'll bend something or you'll break something and it will go up just about the same. I'm the only one that uses it, so it's not really a big deal, but I could put some limit switches in to stop it from going too far up. This is a one-piece gate. This used to be the gate that lifts, or that you would, you know, ride a mower up, but instead of it going up and down like a gate, it opens like a door. So and then there's some springs that hold it in place, and also a chain that doesn't allow it to open too far. Purpose of that is when I dump the trailer, the gate stays in the open position, because that's kind of its default. Those springs are pretty strong, so it stays open. This is the trash can that I put on the dumper. I did put this little piece of angle iron here. I just kind of bolted it on, just so that when that thing closes, the trash can doesn't flip out when it dumps. So I'll take this out and walk around this. Oh yeah, I didn't show you this shovel here. We don't have snow here in Florida, but I do use that to clean up debris or leaves or anything like that. So I made a little rack on the back. Basically, it's just a piece of flat steel that was welded into that particular... I hope this is focusing good, guys. I hope it is. I can't really see very well because of the sun, but anyway, flat steel there. And then I just bent some metal here. This is kind of crude. I have since made a better design for this. This was just something that I came up with while I was thinking about a latch for it. And basically what you do is you grab it here and you just push it over and then you lift it up. This way, if I hit a bump, I don't lose my shovel off the back of the trailer. That's something I've done a few times. So that was, that's the design I came up with there. And then what else do we got? We got, those are my tough springs. I got a water hose here with a little shutoff valve on it. This is to fill up my water tank, which is here. I actually got that tank off of a job like probably 10 years ago. And it's been in a bunch of different positions. I've had stuff screwed to it. So you can see it's, I'm sorry guys. Hope this sunlight, yeah, there we go. Yeah, there's some screws in there. I just put some silicone on them and screwed them in. I am going to make a new tank. I think I'm going to make a 35-gallon tank, and I'm going to put it under the mower in the front of the trailer. I'm going to make it out of Lexan. Or I might make it out of aluminum. I'm not really sure, but I am going to make a bigger tank. This is another one of those light bar lights. The switch for that one is here. This one. And, oh yeah, here's my bypass switch. This switch, when you turn this one on, it turns on all the light bars, including the reverse lights. I use that one, like I said, when I'm outside and it's nighttime and I'm working. Hose reels. This is a pressure washing hose reel. This is a 100-foot standard hose. I have holes drilled in the trailer there. The reason why is because I do some pressure washing, so I just take this pressure washer and I sit it in the back of the dump right there at the edge. And these hoses can go through. This one here, you can unscrew here. You pull out the hose that runs the pressure washer there. Feed through one of them holes there. Sorry, guys. And in the meantime, it sits here so that it doesn't end up dragging behind me. And then this hose here, unhook this, feed this through there, one of those other holes. I take a 100-gallon water tank, sit it in the front of the dump, and then it feeds this pump. This is just a Harbor Freight special. I think I paid $49 for it, but I did weld in a fitting for this pressure switch, and I put a one-way check valve here. Reason why that's the case is because I can feed this with a water tank, and this pump will pump until it hits a certain pressure, and then it'll shut off. Meaning I can use this hose like a regular water hose, and when I pull this, the pump turns on. When I let go and it builds pressure, it shuts off, which it's instantly, basically. So it also allows me to feed my pressure washer, and comes on when it needs and goes off when it doesn't. So it's actually pretty cool. I was pretty happy with this thing because it was such a cheap alternative to what's out there. But because I already had a generator on my trailer, it wasn't really a big deal that it already, you know, that I have power for 120 volts. Whereas a lot of other guys, when they're doing like soft washes or pressure washing and they need a water pump system, they use those even flows or something. And those are pretty expensive. They're 12 volts, so they're great, but they're pretty expensive. And this has just worked better. This is a bypass switch, basically. This is to just make sure that the pump is always off, because I start the generator for a bunch of different reasons. I start it if I need the compressor. I start it if I, if I have to run a cord into the house for lights or something. So this is just to make sure that the pump is always in the off position. That way, when there's no water feeding to it, it doesn't just constantly run and then burn up. But if it did, it's $49. I go get another one. It's not that big of a deal. So this is the hydraulic pump. This came off of one of my box trucks. I used to have box trucks, and I built some hydraulic dovetails. This is a double acting pump with a double acting cylinder, and that's just a standard car battery, really. I know these are not battery clamps. I'm sure I'm going to hear it from everybody. I had an issue a couple of months ago, and I ended up taking the battery clamps off. They broke when I did. I didn't have new ones, so I put some hose clamps on there. Hasn't been an issue, so I left it. I'm sure I'm going to hear shit from people, but that's kind of what it is. It's just a crude battery bracket that I made. Pushes against the battery and keeps it pulled forward so that this lip catches. This here puts pressure on the battery and lifts it. There's a plate under there, so it's not just kind of drilling into the battery there. This battery's been in this location for probably 3 years now and hasn't been a problem. So that is the 12-volt pump that runs my water tank, what I use for filling up buckets or washing my hands over there, like I showed you. And it, you know, obviously it comes from here, but the cool thing is that I can unhook this quick click connector and it will hook into this pump, in a pinch. So, it's only 15 gallons, but you know, you can use it to spray out a refrigerator or spray down some gutters or, you know, whatever you're doing. All right, so I'll lift the trailer up. This is the dump. It lifts about, well, it'll lift 4,000 pounds. I don't put 4,000 pounds in it though, because when you look at it, you'll notice that the dump is actually farther behind the axles than maybe it should be. So about 2,500 pounds is about what I like to try to put in there. If I'm crunching to get a job done, I might top it off or go a little too heavy and just drive home slow. But that's what I do with that. So what else here? I guess I can show you underneath here. That's just kind of crude. That's the system that I came up with to put it in place. It needs to be painted. It's rusty. I've had this trailer in the configuration that it is, as far as the dump is concerned, for about 5 years. So it's kind of a light duty dump. It's basically just a box welded out of metal with some half inch pressure treated plywood on the sides and some 5/8 on the bottom. Make it a little tougher. So I'm gonna pause you and drop the dump real quick. Actually, I guess I could leave it running while I do it. So it double acts, so that means it has power going up and power going down. It's not necessary, it's just what I had, so that's what I used. The pump is definitely more expensive. The cylinder is, I think, is pretty much the same. Actually, no, I think the cylinder is more expensive too, but not by much. So anyway, this is a basket here that I built. It's a little bit longer than 8 feet. Purpose of it is for 2x4s and furring strips. 2x4s if you're boarding windows, furring strips if you're tarping a roof or something, or anything that's 8 feet long. Fence posts if you're doing that kind of stuff. I put my screen rolls in there sometimes if I'm doing screen work. This is the gate that I put in the side of the trailer here. Now this is the part that's kind of a little bit off. When I built the trailer the first time, I did put this gate in the side, but the problem with it was is that I ruined the integrity of the trailer. So when I built the dump in the back, it started to crack in this location right here. I welded it a bunch of times. I put some filler metal in it, and it just wasn't working out. So what I did was I raised the deck up where I would mount the mower so that I could put a larger, thicker piece of metal from here to here. Since then, it hasn't given me any trouble, and there's a lot of dead space down there. I'm not happy about that, but my ladder does fit down there. That's a 6-foot A-frame ladder. Just stays in place. I didn't really do it on purpose. It just worked out that way. The gate is a two-piece. It's 4 feet and 3 feet, so 7 feet total. I'll show you. I can drop it with one hand. There's just a latch here, which pushed the gate a little bit, and that slides out. And then there's a latch over here. This latch is just to keep the secondary part of the gate from swinging out when I make a turn. So basically, you just push that up and pull this out. When you put the gate back up, you drop that and it clips in place, and so it's good to go. But anyways, unclick it here and just grab it and pull it. You can see there's a foot under there on a spring. The spring puts the foot in the right position when the gate comes down so that the gate doesn't fold backwards on accident. And it just gives a little bit of extra support. That's what it looks like. It's got just a single Gorilla Lift. Probably could use two, but I only had room for one because this trailer is full of crap. So the mower I use is kind of a hybrid. Started out as a 34-inch Gravely. It's 40 inches now. The tires are wider. The engine's bigger. The seats has a suspension. The wiring is different. I took all the relays out. The front wheels pivot differently. I took out those plastic bushings and welded in some wheel bearings from a trailer axle. So it's been like that 4 years, and I just grease it every once in a while, and it's they spin so perfectly free. It's actually, I don't know why everybody doesn't do that, because those things are crap. Plastic bushings, I don't know why they do that on a mower. This is a homeowner's mower. Well, or I guess I should say it started as a homeowner's mower, but she's pretty tough now. I changed the way that the belt installs. I changed the type of pulleys. I changed a bunch of things. The spindles are different. There's a lot of stuff. Maybe I'll do a video about that mower a different time, but it's just what I built for myself. It's really more trouble than it's worth, I think, for anybody to try to duplicate it, but it worked for me because of the crap yards I was cutting. So I needed something that I could get belts from Home Depot or Lowe's, and I needed to be able to get blades from anywhere, and I needed to be able to replace the spindles if they broke. But I've had this mower for 9 years, I think, total, and I've replaced one spindle on it. And even then, I didn't really need to replace it. It just, I hit something and it cracked the casing, but it was still spinning fine. So I just replaced it anyway. But this is just a tongue box. The only thing in here really is parts for the trailer and a couple of other small things. I got some extra pulleys for the mower. I got some extra spindles for the trailer, for the axle. I got some bearings for the axle there. I got some grease fittings, or wall grease, air impact, just in case I need to take the blades off. These things actually, I'll show you what the deal is with this. These were my first iteration of how to put the trash can on the dump. I'll show you real quick how that works. I guess I didn't show you. This is my air hose. It's just 100 feet of Harbor Freight air hose. When I'm doing winterizations, I can just start the generator, run the air hose up to the house, and I don't have to take anything out. So that helps. These bars, what they do is they go in here. At this point, when I'm putting my trash can on, I just loosen this up and swing this out, put the trash can in, swing it back closed, and tighten it up. But if I'm at a house and they have some trash cans there too, we can use theirs with these here. This would slide in, and this would just grab the this hook here, grab the edge of the trash can, and then see if I can get this. This is just a bolt. I build a lot of things with stuff that we have. Sometimes I there's a lot of stuff that I use, like bed frame metal for, which is what this thing here is made out of, that holds my bleach and my solution when I'm pressure washing. But you know, these are the bolts we use to board windows, and these are the nuts just welded in place, you know. And and this holds down the trash can. There's one that goes here too, so that's why there's two of them. And it just allows me to use a trash can other than my own for trying to double team something. This is the slope that I built for when you dump. This is just a cheap trash can. I cut it in half, and then I cut the bottom out of the top. And it's flimsy, but it helps direct anything that's in the trash can into the dump so that it doesn't fall out of the, you know, the gate. I think that's pretty much it. I hope that helps. There's a lot of people on YouTube posting a lot of stuff, and they take a lot of time out of their day to teach people how to do things and show their systems and how they work. So I wanted to help with that. kind of feel like a hypocrite learning everything from everybody and then not showing anybody anything. So this is the video. I hope everybody likes it. And if you have any questions or anything, something I didn't cover or whatever, comment on there, and I'll try to get back with you. I'm pulling this with a 2011 Silverado. It's the LS model, nothing special. It's got a 4.8 V8 motor in it. It's not four-wheel drive, it's just regular old truck. I bought it with no miles on it. It's got 193,000 on it now, and it's been pulling this trailer for just about all of that 193,000. The trailer empty, when I say empty, I mean without debris in the back, weighs, I believe, as it sits, right at 5,000 pounds, maybe a little bit lighter. Not much. When I leave the dump, that truck, this trailer, and my toolboxes that are in the back of the truck, my empty weight is right about 4.7 tons. So, not great at math, but what, 9,800 pounds or something like that? If you consider the truck weighs right around 5,000 pounds, I have to assume that the trailer's right around that same weight. Never weighed it by itself, but that's the opinion on it. I think I told you guys the base of it is a six. It started as a 6.5 by 12 foot. It's a little bit longer than that now, but only because of the trash can dumper. It's certainly wider than 6.5. I think it's actually right at 8 feet now with all of the accessories that are on it. So I think as far as DOT is concerned, I'm about as wide as I'm allowed to be. But anyways, again, if you guys have any questions, I'd love to hear them, or even ideas, or if you want to buy one, because I'm going to start building them. So thanks for watching, guys. Bye.